That's because this smaller engine has a dual overhead cam and it's pushing out pretty much the same amount of power that we were having in the stage 2 car last year.
Before we start this video, we want to say a big thank you to Bridgestone India. Bridgestone has been one of the biggest tyre manufacturers in the world, and they've had their hands in almost all types of motorsport. Everything from Formula 1 to Pikes Peak Hill Climb racers. We are proud to say that Bridgestone India has been a keen sponsor in this year's Valley Run project that we're doing. They have given us amazing back-end support, but apart from the back-end support, they create some amazing tyres. We highly recommend their B series of tires if you're looking for something like a reasonably priced tire, but it's also very durable and has good amounts of grip. And if you're a car enthusiast, we highly recommend you to check out the Turanza and Potenza lineup of tires, which are proper enthusiast tires. So if you're looking for some new tires, do check out Bridgestone India.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Road to Valley Run. Today is the turn of the tiny little 1 liter Polo that we've got. We usually do 1.2s, but this time we've got an actual pocket rocket. This 1 liter engine can push out much more than the 1.2. Check it out. As you guys can see, and as you guys are already familiar with, we are already uploading our stage 1 file for our A4 category car. Yeah, this is a stage 1 file. Last year we were running a stage 2 file, but this year we're going to be having a different engine. Yup, this is a 1 litre 3 cylinder engine, 200cc less. One cylinder less, but it is still going to make more power, and that's because it's a DOHC. It has a dual overhead cam setup. So that means the top end in the rev range is quite more aggressive, which means we can push out more power from a smaller, tinier engine. What you can see right here is the ECU. We didn't get a chance to film the removal, but because it was the first time mapping this specific engine, we had to remove the ECU, but we didn't get to do it. But now we're uploading everything, stage 1 file gonna be done, and maybe let's just take it for a spin, see how it is. So we are out of the garage with the Polo. We are gonna be taking some logging runs and see how the car actually performs on paper. Usually Niranjan is there to do it with us, but I'm pretty sure after so many cars, he trusts us, and I think he knows that we understand what to do. So let's just go through the rev ranges. Okay, fourth gear. So now what I'm gonna be doing is going from the bottom of the rev range to the top of the rev range in every gear, or mainly third, fourth and fifth, so that we can see what is the peak power. And I will do second as well, because we are setting the car up for a drag race, which means that our lower gears need to have the entire that's how you record the entire rev range all the way up to the rev and finish the gear. So now I'm gonna put it in manual and record third gear. So now we are at the bottom of the rev range and my foot is down to the ground, and yep. Just like that, we've got the data. I'm gonna send this. I'm gonna take the car back down to Niranjan and he's gonna do his magic, because I can do this much. So there you go, folks, a ready stage 1 Polo for the A4 category. Smaller engine, more output. That's because this smaller engine has a dual overhead cam and it's pushing out pretty much the same amount of power
that we were having in the stage 2 car last year. This is going to be pushing around 130 bhp. So did our old stage 2 1.2 liter TSI run. So we have quite high hopes from this. See you guys at the Valley Run. Till then, take care, peace.